This landing of the Mars rover named Curiosity is the kind of hair-raising thing you'll want to watch live because its success is not a sure thing. Previous spacecraft have been lost while attempting to land on Mars. Then there's the must-make-your-mark landing and the relatively tiny 3-mile target on the red planet. Add in the $2.5 billion price tag of the rover and you've got a high-stakes mission and a rare and exciting one that you and your friends and family can watch together live at the Reuben H Fleet Science Center. Here to talk about the mission and event is Dr. Lisa Will, Reuben H Fleet resident astronomer, and Jerry Hilburn, NASA Jet Propulsion Lab Solar System Ambassador. Thank you both for being here. Jerry, the Curiosity took off from Earth in November. What is its mission?
It's going there to study the surface of the planet for geology, to determine its chemical makeup, to characterize the weather patterns on the planet, to determine what the radiation levels are like on the planet, and to also see what the water is like. Is it close to the surface? Is it in the materials itself? Its mission is designed to determine 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, for the 2 years it's on the surface, what conditions are like in preparation for sending astronauts to the planet. We need to know if it's safe.
If it's safe to send astronauts, we're going to come back to that because I do want to talk about sending people to Mars. First, Dr. Will, the fleet does plan to show a few short films that details the dangerous parts of this mission. What are those dangerous parts?
The most dangerous part of the mission is actually the landing itself. Once the spacecraft enters the atmosphere of Mars, it'll experience what NASA is referring to as the 7 minutes of terror, because the spacecraft will be out of touch with mission control for those 7 minutes as it goes through the atmosphere and then lands. Mars has a very thin atmosphere, but it's still enough that you have to enter the atmosphere at just the right angle so that you can not break up upon entry. But also, it's not a thick enough atmosphere to slow the spacecraft enough down to land safely all on its own. And so there will be a parachute deployed during the 7 minutes, and then also something that is a space crane, which will be the first time this has ever been attempted during a mission landing on Mars, that will help control the descent under power of the spacecraft till it lands.
There's rocket boosters too, right, to lift it up?
Yeah, there's rocket boosters on the space crane. Basically, what will happen is that a space crane will be deployed with the rover underneath. The crane itself will have rocket boosters that will control the descent, and then the crane will detach, leaving the lander on the surface, and the crane will actually fly a safe distance away, because they were worried that the rockets would actually kick up so much dust that you would cover the instruments on the rover itself.
We can't have that.
No.
The 7 minutes of terror, that is when NASA will have no communication with the rover, and we won't be able to see that part at the fleet.
What will happen during that time is we'll be showing the NASA feed. So what we'll be seeing are the people's reactions in mission control as they're waiting, just as we'll be waiting along with them to figure out if the mission has successfully landed. What will happen is if the rover lands successfully, it will communicate within a few minutes to a spacecraft that is orbiting around Mars currently, and that spacecraft will give us back the signal saying whether or not it successfully landed. So the landing is currently scheduled to happen at 10:31 on Sunday night, and we should know within 2 minutes whether or not the landing has been a success.
And you'll be able, we'll be getting the NASA feed at Fleet,
yes,
and also whatever images NASA is feeding back from the rover, minus those 7 minutes.
Right. What will happen is that the spacecraft needs to sort of unpack and test all of its instruments. So there will not be suddenly images of Mars showing up from the rover on Sunday night, but Monday morning definitely there will be. What we'll be seeing Sunday night is whether or not the mission was a success, the reaction of the scientists.
Okay, Jerry, before we get to putting astronauts on Mars, that was a surprise. Scientists at NASA have said that they're actually not looking for life on Mars. They're looking for the ingredients of life on Mars. What are they looking for, and how are they going to get that?
Well, the idea is that we want to study the planet's surface to determine what the characteristics of the planet's surface is like for people who might be eventually living there. So while the equipment is not really designed or set up to go out and detect whether or not there's life on Mars, it is its mission, its purpose, is to go out and determine whether or not a human being might be able to survive on Mars down the road.
All right. Thank you very much, and thank you for joining us. Now, the Curiosity live viewing at the Reuben H. Fleet Science Center in Balboa Park is this Sunday night. The doors will open at 7:30. Tickets are $5 for children and up to $10 for adults.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.